We're going to first discuss the grip. The grip is probably the most important area of the golf swing, mainly because it's the only contact you have with the club throughout the swing. So I want to do this little drill with you guys at home, and if you can sort of go ahead and place your left hand in front of you, and this is for a right-handed golfer, we're going to want the club to sit from the knuckle of this left hand to the base pad of this pinky. All right, that is basically the fingers of our left hand. If you can do that and go ahead and hinge the club up this way, you can feel how your wrists will work this way. This is a tremendous source of power for you in your golf swing. If you do not have that, you're gonna have a hard time swinging the club. Vice versa, if you're at home watching this right now, go ahead and place the club right in the lifeline of your left hand, just like this. So this is where most people, if you see that your glove is worn out in this spot, you know that the club is sitting way too high up in the palm. This is robbing you of distance and accuracy. So place the club in the lifeline, and this is just for demonstration purposes. Try to hinge your wrist now. You'll notice it's going to be much more difficult. You're going to try to use your elbow and even your body to create that power. So again, we want to see the club in the fingers of the left hand. A couple drills that you can do for this, if you just hold your right hand on the shaft and you hold the club at 45 degrees, it's going to naturally sit like that. A lot of times, people, when the club is sitting on the ground like this, they want to put their hand on there, and you're going to see that naturally it wants to go into the lifeline. That's why it's very difficult when the club is sitting on the ground like this to put the club in the fingers. So again, let's go back up here with the club at a nice 45 degree angle. You just place your hands on it from that position. And from face on, what you're going to see here when you place the club down, you'll see that the V formed by my thumb and forefinger will point towards my right ear. That's where we want it. That's a nice neutral grip. When looking down from here without moving my head, I can see my first knuckle, second knuckle, and maybe part of my third knuckle, just maybe half of it. So 2.5 knuckles of the left hand is a good neutral grip at this point.